Hello, bands. New music, band interviews, emerging artists, and signed acts. Hello-bands.com.
On? New music now. Mic check.
Time to play the game.
All right, it's Mike. We are ready for Pretty Vicious.
Time to play the game.
All right, we have the chance to speak with Elliot, the drummer of Pretty Vicious. They are out of Wales, and they just came off of a gig last weekend at Singleton Park. And how you guys doing? Good to hear from you. Say hello.
Hello, this is Elliot. I'm currently the only member of the band who is available to talk to because everyone else is busy making our debut record. Just below me, actually. I'm currently upstairs in the studio. We're all doing great. We just got back from a great gig with Noel Gallagher in Singleton Park in Swansea, which is about 20 miles from our hometown. So, yeah, that was insane. Plenty of people we knew there, and that was probably cool. But, yeah, we're all doing really well.
All right, well, cool. Good to hear. Sounds like it was a good gig. And let's get to your guys' band name. How did you guys come up with that name? By the way, it is a pretty cool name, especially I think it really represents your guys' music, really, generally speaking. So how did you guys come up with that?
Well, basically our name came from the fact that we wanted something to sum up the ethos of the band. And I mean, we went so long without a name. I mean, it was 9 months after we formed. We'd had all these tunes done, all these demos recorded, and we had record label interest and our first two gigs lined up, and we still had no name. I mean, we went through some pretty terrible names as well. I'm not going to bother repeating because it's pretty ridiculous. But we eventually settled on Pretty Vicious because, as I said, we wanted something to sum up what the band was all about.
All right, on a non-music topic here, but still have to do with Wales. It's been a couple of months since the Euros, but as you know, being from Wales, you know, football is a big thing in the UK. They did quite well in the Euros, and were you able to check it out or see some of the stuff? And how did you guys get on with that?
Yeah, we were in the studio at the time when the Euros first started. I mean, we'd seen the group, we'd seen it, the draw. It was against England, Slovakia, and Russia. I can't remember if it was Slovakia or not. It was 2 months ago now. But we watched every game, I think it was. I mean, we had time off in between studio sessions as well, like a
That's
week.
Cool.
So we got to watch the Belgium game and, unfortunately, the Portugal game in our local pub back in Merv Tydfil. And the atmosphere was incredible. I mean, it was just so nice to see so much support for the national squad, and
but it was nuts.
The entire place was bouncing. It was insane. But now we were really happy with how well Wales did in the Euros. It's remarkable.
All right, we're gonna take a break for just a second and put on one of your guys' tunes. We'll put on Black and Blue. This is off of their Cave Song EP. It's Pretty Vicious. It's Mic Check, No Alternative Radio.
Shake up, I'm scared. Wake up, he's here. Out of control, there's trouble and he's drinking and he's looking for more. Footsteps. We'll be right back.
All right, we are back with Elliot of Pretty Vicious, the drummer of the band, and they are from Wales. And I just got done speaking about the Euros briefly there from the summer. Wales did quite well. And but back to your guys' music and touring and playing live. You guys have had a lot of great acts that you guys have been able to play with, you know, in the past. You know, obviously, just last weekend, you played with Noel Gallagher and Frightened Rabbit, another one. And you've played with other Wales bands like Manic Street Preachers and Wolf Alice and festivals and just been lots of tons of great bands you've been touring with. What are you guys' thoughts on that, or was at least your thoughts in particular?
I mean, yeah, we've worked with quite a few big acts now. I mean, we supported the Manic Street Preachers, we've supported Noel Gallagher, we've supported the Phonics, you know, we've played with loads more massive artists, and all it just gives us a reminder of the sort of work we need to put in to become, you know, get to the very top. And yeah, I mean, that's the best thing about it. It shows how much work you have left to do. I mean, it's great having all these tunes, but it shows you everything else you've got to do, you know, live performances and stuff. It's just something to aspire to, you know, beat. I mean, back in the day, I mean, Brad's favorite band growing up was always the Phonics, and now we've actually supported them, we've shared a stage with them, and they've gone from being heroes to being, you know, competition almost. I mean, that's the best way to look at it, because obviously we want to get to the very top, you know, sell platinum records, whatever. What band wouldn't?
Yeah, well, with you guys being teenagers and all, and how is that with your guys' families? And are you guys pretty much left on your own, or does your parents have any say in your guys' you know, tour or your production of your album or anything like that? Or you guys just have sort of winging it, or you have, I'm sure you have some professional help at some point, but you know, how is it with your family involved with your guys' band and all that stuff?
Yeah, my father, Bryn Phillips, is actually the manager of the band, and he formed a management label called Black Sheep Industries. And so yeah, he's obviously still really heavily involved, and it's not like I'm any father managing the band or anything. He's a great manager on his own. And who else am I going to trust? I mean, some manager from London who I've never met and never done trust, or my own family. I mean, it's an easy choice. Plus, I mean, the manager's probably cooler than us anyway, so, you know.
That is a great point. You know, I guess family, hopefully you're in the situation like yourself that your family is someone you can trust, so that worked out really well for you guys then, having your father do the management. So with that said, you guys obviously have been quite busy over the last year and a half. Does he give you some time off, or are you guys available to have any free time to do anything else?
I mean, this year we've had basically no free time at all. I mean, between recording the debut album, you know, creating our own artwork and stuff, touring, I mean, we've got a tour coming up in September now, which we can't wait for. We've had no time whatsoever to do anything we want, but I mean, that's obviously how we want it. I mean, we joined the band to be away and to do, you know, cool stuff. And, you know, it's been amazing. So I'm not going to complain about having no free time, because I'd much rather be doing this.
So when it comes to playing live, do you have a preference to, you know, like a small venue, small club, or a big, huge festival type crowd? Do you have an actual preference, or does it really matter to you guys? You just want to be out there and play?
Our favorite places to play are just wherever the crowds are best. I mean, you can play a large venue or, you know, massive festival, you can play a tiny club, and the best gig will always be where you can feed off the crowd and get loads of energy off the crowd. So that could be any small venue you play, or it could be any large venue you play. It all depends on the day, really.
As our listeners probably already know, you know, back in the autumn in Paris, they had the terror attack, and that band Eagles of Death Metal, the American band, was on stage, and that was the site of one of the attacks. And people don't know this, but actually you guys were actually playing the same night as they were. Can you tell me what your thoughts were going through all that and everything through the night?
Yeah, we were less than 2 miles away from the Bataclan when that happened, and there was no one left in the streets. I mean, we were playing our gig, and people were just leaving, and we thought, well, we couldn't be this bad, surely not. We were looking over to the tour manager and stuff, and he was telling us, after I asked him, and he said he was telling us to get off stage, but we didn't know what he was saying. So we finished the show, and when we got off stage, we were told what was happening, and there were still a few people left in the venue, and they actually locked us in to stop us from going outside, because we were so close to the attack. It was going on right around us. We ended up having to basically ran back to our hotel with like free people from the gig, free French people from the gig, because they had nowhere else to go.
That's crazy. All right, well, let's get on a brighter note here. So you guys, like you mentioned, are working the finishing touches on your new album. Can you tell me when's it going to be released and some more info about it?
We're looking to release this album early 2017. I mean, it's looking like spring, but we've got to get all the singles done. We've got to get all mixed and mastered. We've got to get all the artwork done for it. We've got to get all the promotion done for it. There's so much left to do. But hopefully we can get it done by spring 2017, because I'm doing this interview the final day of album recording. We're leaving in about 3 hours, and it's sounding insane. We cannot wait to release this album.
Well, looking forward to that. If it's anything like your previous singles and EP, it should be pretty rad. Anything else to tell us? Maybe a tour or anything before you head on out of this?
Yeah, we're going to be touring the UK starting in 2 weeks, you know, end of September. We're all up and down the UK. We've been looking forward to these shows now for months, and they're all nearly sold out, so it's just going to be an amazing experience. So we hope to see as many people there as possible.
All right, cool. Well, thanks, Elliot, and good luck to you guys on your guys' tour coming up and finishing up your album debut. In the meantime, we'll finish it off here with the Cave Song. Of course, you can get that from iTunes or Amazon, or you can stream it on Spotify, Apple Music, and you can also get their EP from their website. 10-inch single has all 4 songs. So thanks again to Elliot and Pretty Vicious. This is The Cave Song. It's an alternative radio mic check.
And I'm bored. We've been waiting by the shops for like an hour just to get to catch a boy's hand. But days is slowly drag. This is called the local slacks and sing it louder. And we are all happy boys. Singing, drinking in the chaos. Oh, no, yeah. Singing, drinking. Children of the streets, listen to a word about tomorrow. This the world is at our best, mad. So try and just relax. Smoke another fag and ease your sorrows. This is lots of all I need. Singing, sneaking in the chaos. Oh, no, yeah. Singing.
Hello, bands. New music, band interviews, emerging artists, and signed apps. Hello-bands.com.